Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. A while back on the Smarter Every Day subreddit, someone made a post that said something like, "No one ever believes that I can talk backwards." This caught my eye, and I watched the video, and it was fascinating. It's a skill this guy has clearly worked very, very hard on. If you remember in the backwards bicycle video, when I was first learning, if I had a phone in my pocket that rang when I was trying to do it, it would break that skill instantly, and I would no longer be able to steer. It's really curious how the brain works. I asked this guy if he would come to Alabama and basically become a human test subject and let me try to test the limits of this skill. I'm really excited because he actually accepted my invite, and today on Smarter Every Day, we're gonna get to test someone's brain trying to talk backwards. Let's do it.
This is Kurt Quinn, and is it a talent or a skill?
I think it's a skill.
A skill that you can acquire?
I think it's something that,
Okay, so Kurt can do this thing. He can talk backwards, and I have questions. So first I want to demonstrate the skill,
okay,
and then I'm going to put you in stranger and stranger situations until I see if I can break it.
So my brain
doesn't... Yeah, how many words can you start with?
Let's start with one word and gradually work up.
Okay,
is that okay?
Really?
Yeah,
that's how it works.
Yeah, because it after a while it gets easier and easier as I do it.
Okay, let's start with this.
Gets into it. Okay,
banjo.
Wajnab.
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 Okay.
The banjo.
Okay. Say, I'm in Alabama with a banjo on. Can I get your banjo out?
Sure.
Okay, go ahead.
Move my underwear off it.
Okay. I'm in Alabama with a banjo on my knee.
I'm in Alabama with a banjo on my knee. Inyamna wajnaba thu amabala nimya.
This is bizarre, dude.
I'm in Alabama with a banjo on my knee.
I'm impressed. Okay.
Okay, I know this is kind of strange, but there is a method to my madness. I'm going to start simple by just demonstrating the skill and then slowly ramp up the weirdness with animals. Eventually, I want to see if I can completely task saturating by doing different kinds of distractions and just see what his brain does as a reaction.
You ever held a chicken?
No, I haven't. Nikishta. I'm holding a chicken.
This cat's name is Ganymede.
Demonagze mienze staxiv. This cat's name is Ganymede. Schiff.
Dirty fishbowl.
Lubschiff eaterd. Dirty fishbowl.
Oh, shift feeder.
Fish.
What else do I have?
He has 50 animals, and none of them... I have to hold 50 of 50 animals?
Bunny rabbit.
Tibarinub. Bunny rabbit. God.
Is that how it works?
Yeah.
Okay. My dog's name is Buckshot.
Tashkub ze mien zgadyam. My dog's name... is Buckshot.
When I started to think about the physics of speech, I started to gain a much deeper appreciation for the algorithm that his brain has created. Think about it this way. In the English alphabet, there are 26 letters, but in the International Phonetic Alphabet, there are 107 letters. If you think about that, it's not that he's actually reading the letters of a word backwards. He has to phonetically recreate the sounds those letters are making backwards. Okay, I think this might be awkward, but I think it's worth it. Think about your mouth as a control volume. You have a tongue inside, and you have teeth, and the interaction between your tongue and your teeth restrict and allow airflow in certain directions. On the outside, you have lips that can hold back pressure, and then they can release that pressure all at once. To appreciate what his brain is doing, you have to understand that there's some physical sounds you can't make backwards. For example, plosives. Plosives are where you pressurize the inside of your mouth and then you briefly let it go. For example, puh, buh, kuh, guh, tuh, duh. Those are plosives. The fact that you can create those backwards is very strange because if you look at a spectrogram of those sounds, you have this very sharp spike where the sound starts and then this release of air, puh. Ba, ka, ga, ta. In order for us to hear what he's saying backwards, he has to fake a plosive, because you can't instantly, like in a matter of milliseconds, repressurize air and make it sound good. So he has tricks that he's using to make it sound like a duh, puh, tuh. It's really interesting.
For example, the CH sound, ch, backwards is sht.
Can you do it while you play your banjo?
I've never tried.
Okay, say rainbow.
What in the air? Rainbow.
Is it hard?
It's super hard.
Okay. Too much. Yeah, I'm not going to tell you until you're rolling. Leprechaun.
Knuckle player.
Knuckle player? Real. Oh, God.
And this went up. Oh, man.
Okay, so was it harder?
Yeah.
Okay, what was your brain doing during that?
I felt good while I was doing this song that I've played a million times. And then you threw the word in, and then my brain just forgot about this. That's interesting.
Is this embarrassing to you?
I mean, a little.
Why does it bother you that you didn't get it right? This isn't like a challenge.
Yeah, it is.
What, is it?
Give me a break. What are we doing if not trying to do it right?
Okay. Leprechaun.
Knuckle player.
Your face. It was like I could see the gears go.
Okay, the grand finale. My friends Jared and Daniel wanted to help me come up with a situation that would completely task saturate his mind. So this video that you're about to see starts immediately after the safety brief, which is when he understood that there were going to be two rifles on each side of him firing at an array of bottles in the field while a drone is hovering overhead recording the whole event. It was really fun. But one thing I find super interesting is that the sound of the AK as it fires is just like a plosive. It's the rapid release of pressurized gas. So when we play it backwards, think about that gas repressurizing, and that's what a plosive sound sounds like when played in reverse.
So Jared and Daniel are gonna be going after these bottles, and I'm gonna be yelling words at you, okay?
All right.
So the first word is ready.
Eat air.
Aim.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Fire.
Hurry up.
Okay, AK-47.
Need that cedro. Yeah.
The drone is descending. We have many bottles left.
12 Zuldabinem Vahiu.
I am from California.
Einrola Vak Marf Mia.
Are we out of bottles?
Zuldabadwaira.
Okay, clear the weapons. All right, put the weapons down.
I'm Mabula Hoot McClow. Welcome to Alabama.
No, it's not about with the Sierra. It's not about with the
gecko. Hurry out with the bubbles.
Slow down, Blair.
I'm from California.
Are you black or fair?
We have many bubbles left.
Kyle, slow down, I've been invading.
The drone is descending.
Yes, yes, it's in order.
AK-47. Fire.
Help.
Aim.
Me.
Ready.
Okay, that was a super fun video, and I just wanted to show you that we have ducks as well. We really like animals. Anyway, today's sponsor is who I want to say thank you to, and that is Audible. We have a book that we've been reading together, don't we? What is it?
Harry Potter. I know you're in chapter, aren't you in chapter 9?
Maybe. Anyway, you can go in there. We'll go talk about it a little bit later. You're in chapter 11? Awesome. So here's the deal. I use Audible to stay relevant in my kids' lives. He likes to read. I want to encourage that. He enjoys Harry Potter. So what I'm doing is, even though I don't have a lot of time, on my way to work, I am listening to the Harry Potter book so that when I come home at night, I have something I can relate to with my son. Can you do the pirate thing? He is in the second book now, and I am listening to the same books that he does just because I want to be able to have intelligent conversations with my 8-year-old. Anyway, audible.com/smarter is the way you can get a free trial, and that would really be a big help for Smarter Every Day. In all seriousness, please consider supporting Smarter Every Day by going to audible.com/smarter and getting a free trial. As you can see from my son's face, he really enjoys the fact that I'm staying relevant with him. Anyway, also, Kurt wanted to tell you the URL backwards so that you can remember it.
Trumps shall smock toddle bada. audible.com/smarter.
Yed Yirtre?
Nope.
Dang it.
Yed Yirvet Yirtrums. Smarter every day.
It's so silly, but it feels so good.
Doesn't it? Yeah. It's so satisfying.
If you want to see some of Kurt Quinn's skills, this is Smarter Every Day. He's got his own YouTube channel. It's Kurt
Just
Quinn.
It's called Kurt Quinn.
Yeah. He's got some really interesting skills. This one was pretty cool, but I think my favorite is the fact that you are a world record banjo player.
Yeah, I hold the world record for the world's fastest banjo player.
I love that video. Go check that out. Now, please consider subscribing. He would never say that. Actually, you don't even say that on your channel, do you?
Sometimes I say Bjark's bus.
Okay. Anyway, check it out, and you can Bjark's bus over whenever you want. Anyway, I really appreciate your time, and you're going to stick around and do a podcast with us?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. If you want to hear us talk to Kurt Quinn on our podcast, No Dumb Questions, I'll leave a link to that as well. So I think that's it. Anything else?
No, thanks, man.
All right. It was awesome. Thank you very much.
Boom.
Have a good one.
Yob.
What does that mean?
Bye.
All right, backwards bite. Give it a shot. So when your brain clicks into backwards talking mode, yeah. Is it like a click that happens, or?
No. Well, maybe, yeah, because after I do it for a while, I warm up.
Yeah.
It gets easier. Is that what it was like when you...
Same thing.
Yeah.
Give it a shot.
Click.